day, all night, Miss Marianne. Down by the seashore sifting sand, all the little children join in the band. Down by the seashore sifting sand, let's fall a little bit. All day, all night, Miss Marianne. Down by the seashore sifting sand, all the little children join in the band. Down by the seashore, sifting sand. Such Trinidadian folk songs. We can imagine that you're sitting on a beach while you're singing this. All day, all night, Miss Marianne. Ready, sing.
All day, all night, Miss Marianne.
Down by the seashore, sifting sand. Ready, sing.
Down by the seashore, sifting sand.
All the little children join in the band. Many sing.
All the little children join in the band.
Down by the seaside is Marianne. Ready, sing.
Down by the seaside is Marianne.
Excellent, let's try the whole thing. Ready, sing. All day, all night, Miss Marianne. Down by the seaside, sifting sand. All the little children join in the band. Down by the seaside, sifting sand. One more time, I want you to start thinking about the solfege. Maybe you can do it on the bum this time. Bum 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 bum. Bum ba 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 da. Bum ba 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 da. Ba 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 ya ba da. This time we're going to start to do the solfege, but we're actually going to take about 15 seconds. I want you to go through silently in your head, audiate silently in your head, and see if you can think about the solfege. If it's helpful to do hand signs, you might do mi, so, do, mi, audiate silently in your head, bum, 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 audiate. Excellent. If you want to do hand signs, that's great. If you just want to try it on solfege, that's also okay. Bum bum bum. Bum 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 on solfege.
Mi so do mi mi re fa. Re fa ti re.
The middle, so from do tot all the way over, I want you guys to sing a bass line. I'm not going to say anything else, just sing a bass line. Everyone over here, we're going to sing the melody on solfege. Bum bum bum, here we go. Bum.
Mi so do mi mi re fa.
I heard some other things that were other harmony lines. We're going to get to those really, really soon. For now, just use do and sol. I'm going to do a demonstration on the xylophone. Let's switch so let's have this entire half from Tori all the way over. I want you doing a bass line on do and sol. This half will just do the melody. Let that person in. Bum, bum, bum. Here we go.
or bass line. I need one person to come up and try my xylophone. Who is ready to try the xylophone today? Dotan, come on up. Even though the rest of us are just saying do, and so you can do an alternating board tune. Bum, 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 bum,
bum.
Baseline, we'll sing it twice. You're gonna switch to the other one after you're done. Bum bum bum. Ready, sing. Mi sol do mi
mi re fa. Re fa fa ti re re do mi. Mi sol do mi mi re fa. Re fa fa ti re.
Switch your bar and here we go, man. Excellent. So our clave pattern is 1, 2, 3, ba ba ba, ba ba ba, ba ba ba, and let's move on. So the melody is one way we can find our way through this tune. The bass line is another way we can find our way through the tune. Let's add another harmony. I want some people to choose me. When we go from me to our five chord, we're going to go up to our fa, and you stay there, and then we're going to come back down to our mi. You choose any part you want. You can start on B5, you can start on the bass line, or you can start on the melody. Bum, 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 here we go.
Mi, do, re, mi, fa. Fa, mi, mi, do, re, fa, fa, mi,
go to the next part. Just given sort of diatonic harmony, what is another path we could take through this, starting on a tonic chord, moving to a dominant and back? So our bass line is going do, and then down to so, and then back up to do. Imagine you're writing a four-part harmony, and you have another part that's going mi, fa, mi. What's a note we could start on? So if we start on so, where are we going to go when we switch to the five chord? On the five chord? No. We're going to stay on so your part is going to be... Actually, I forget what order I did this in. Oh, we'll come back to that in a second. What's the other one? So, that will be one of our parts. There's one other part we just fit in here that works really well. Oh, I had your do re. What else do we have? We could do do re, or we could do...
Do ti.
Do ti, exactly. That's probably the more common, so that we're absolutely sure to have a leading tone in our five. So, pick a new part. We need some people doing do. D, D, Do. Anyone else can pick any other part? Let's go from the top. Bum, bum, bum. Ready, sing.
Do.
So is the best note because it works with so many different chords. Let's try this one more time. Pick a part you haven't done or you didn't do last time. We'll do it twice through. So you should do one and then move to the next one.
Bum, bum, bum. Pick your part. So. So.
Oh, one up, Veronica. Jotani, you can say that to make sure she's playing the right part. I believe in you, Veronica, but we'll have Jotani just in case. Say, ba 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 ba.
Ba 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 ba.
Ba 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 ba.
Ba 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 ba.
Ba 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 ba.
Ba 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 ba.
Ba 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 ba.
Ba 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 ba.
Give me something different. Ba 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 ba.
Ba 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 ba.
Ba 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 ba.
Ba 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 ba
ba ba ba ba ba ba
ba ba ba ba ba ba.
Excellent. Our next step in our process is going to be taking those rhythms and applying to our harmony lines. So as you move around the circle, and let's do it at least 3 or 4 times this time, I want you to apply some rhythmic improvisation to each of those lines. So when you're on do, 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 ti, 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 do, 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 what is going to make sort of a succinct and strong improvisation when we're just on like 2 notes like this? Any thoughts? How to make this awesome?
Rhythmic variation.
Rhythmic variation? Is a thought, absolutely. So you might want to not do do, 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 ti, ti.
What is the issue if we
do too much rhythmic variation?
It all sounds like a blur and you can't really tell what's going on.
Exactly. So we want to find that balance between doing something interesting but doing something that might repeat itself. Maybe you're using the rhythmic idea twice in a row. So it sort of like sounds like a police hole. All right, everyone, from the top, we're going to get out instruments after this. Bum, bum, bum. Choose your part. Me, 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 fa, 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 fa. We are in G major. I want you to just take 1 minute and make sure you can play this melody. Let's sort of spread. We might need to spread out a little bit, so if you need to bring a chair out or stand away from the wall. Thank you. I'm awesome.
Absolutely.
Okay. left off. So this, I think I have it. Oh, nope. Ooh.
No. There we go. Alright, we're gonna pick up right here.
Pick a part. You can either be any of the parts. Same thing we did, but on our instruments this time. Let's say you're playing the so-so-so part. In comparison to the other parts, how loud do you think that part should be?
Very
loud. Very loud. That's one option. If we're thinking about creating a nice sounding arrangement where the melody is featured, if you're playing a harmony part or a bass part, you might choose to play a little bit quieter so we can hear the melody part. All right, bum bum bum, here we go. Do, mi, do.
Do, mi, do.
So, mi, so.
So, mi, so.
So, do, mi.
So, do, mi.
Mi, do, so.
Mi, do, so. Thank you.
dominant, and then we'll do a dominant, and then we'll do a tonic. Again, you can play any ones within the function. You do not need to play the one I'm playing. Your turn. Let's keep it on that same rhythm, just bum, 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 rest, bum, ba, etc. Bum, bum, ba, here's tonic. I consolidated all our harmony parts, so if you get to this part of our cycle, you should just improvise any rhythm on the harmony part, similar to what we just did. When you get down here, this is the new part. I want you to do a macro beat improvisation just on chord tones. This is not a time to get super creative and do lots of weird things. It should sound something like... all the way through. You might insert some rest there, but this is going to be our first sort of real improvisation. Pick a part. We'll do three times around, so you get to do three of these things. Again, if you are in this land, or maybe even for now this land, let's keep it like a little bit quieter so we can really start to hear the people who are improvising about that. Bum, bum, bum. Bum, bum, bum. Pick your part. Come up with some more variety. Pick your part, we'll move three times through. One, two, three, four, one, two,
thank you.
this is a free for all for our last time through, then we'll talk a little bit about any rhythms with passing tones is another way to say it. Last time, and let's go all the way through the cycle so everyone gets a chance for all four this time. All the way through, so pick your part and you'll move through each one. Let's pick it up a little bit. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, and here we go. Like, why would we not go up on stage and perform it like this? We could, okay, we would, yes. But why might we choose to do something slightly different?
Yeah. So there's like a balanced amount of each part.
Yes, we want to balance this out a little bit. And also we want the people who really want to step forward and improvise to have that opportunity to do that, so we need to be up to here. So we're going to come up with a final form. I want to give as many people a chance to take a solo as they want. You don't have to if you don't want to. We'll start with the melody, and because we have a variety of instruments, why don't we do the melody twice at the beginning and twice at the end? Can we have all brass players start us on the melody? And everyone else can either play some kind of harmony part or a bass part. And then let's have strings do the melody the second time. Sound good? Who would like to take a solo? I was expecting all hands to go. Thank you, AJ. So we'll have AJ take a quick solo. The rest of us will be quietly supporting you in the background. So if you don't want to, that's okay. I will take 1 second, so thank you. Now, AJ and then me. Anyone else? Please, anyone. No?
Thank you, Dr. Parker.
So we have 3 solos. Can we get 4? Can we get 1 more? Can we get 1 more?
Okay, that's a thank you, Dotan.
Is there anyone who maybe want to do like a duet solo with someone? Like maybe they're not feeling really comfortable about doing it by themselves, but maybe like having a partner playing something next to you. The two of you.
Kyle will.
Excellent. Thank you, Bailey and Kyle. You will be our final solo. And then let's take it out with woodwinds playing the melody, followed by all other instruments who have to play the melody. So we have brass, strings, Adrian, me, Dr. Parker, Dotan, pair over here. Woodwinds on the melody, everyone else on the melody. I'll yell that out as we go through. Sound good? I think actually before we do our final form, I want to share one thing with you. And if you want to sit down, no, please stay standing. We're a little bit of inspiration. I want to play you one of the earlier recordings I was able to find of this. I did not learn this tune from this. I learned this from a book that I'll share with you in a second. But looking through YouTube and looking for sort of the most authentic recording I could find, this was what I came up with. So enjoy. This is Roaring Lion, which I think they're like a calypso band in the 50s or so from Trinidad. So we'll just listen to this in inspiration. Notice maybe some of the things that we didn't incorporate.
Or a day or a night with Mary Ann.
It's slightly different. Also slightly different.
Thank you.
again. Everyone did a fantastic job. That'll be all for instruments for now, so you can go ahead and find a seat if you want to quickly. You might start thinking about that whole process you went through and how you might discuss it, how you might describe it. What were the different steps that we went through before throwing people in the deep end and making them improvise? What was the difference between sort of exploring and improvising? What are your thoughts? Where did we start? Where did we end up? What were the steps in between?
Well, like for me, I like get really anxious every time I go to play the xylophone because I'm like so uncomfortable doing it. But I really like by the end, just like with trying out like different chords and like moving, I like, finally was like, okay, MG, here are the chords, here are the notes I can use. So then I could just like, I like through exploring, I like realized that I can improvise, and you know what I mean. I feel like I explored first and then I
yeah.
Yeah, absolutely. I'm so glad to hear that. What else? Thinking specifically, like, what were the steps that we went through to get from playing the tune to something more present? Jason?
A lot of people are just, like, auditing it, like you just saying, we just kind of like, repeat it back to you, and then later on, we just kind of, like, slowly build on top of that. So everybody knew the melody, everybody knew the bass line, and then it was like, oh, now try the chord roots for the melody, and then so on. So.
Exactly. So this is not, when we improvise, we don't necessarily want to think about improvising over chords outside of the context of a tune. Most of the time we have a melody that we're going to be either referencing or using as a guide for our improvisation. So having that melody sort of present at the very beginning is really important. Yeah. Sam, did you have something?
Well, I was just going to say just like how we started like considering about instruments at all, like being the only one that
yeah.
had an instrument. And then to be able to go, like a lot of what Jason said, but just to be able to, like we learned this tune by singing at first.
Right.
We didn't have any type of notation or anything, but we were so confident and comfortable with the melody from singing and auditing at first that we were able to translate it to primary and secondary.
Exactly, yeah. You guys were real good at learning that tune really quickly. I wouldn't expect younger students to do that, but I'm so glad that you guys were really confident in that. Excellent.
What else? What about,
what do you think, how would you describe the difference between exploration and improvisation? Marissa touched on this, but let's try to be more specific. Let's go to Dota.
If you had just said, here's the tune, let's improvise, I think most people would just be like freeze up. But because you started with like very strict limitations, and then our only job is just to explore, like, all right, you got two notes, pick one and you can improvise a rhythm, but like that's the only thing that you're gonna be focusing on, it's like more manageable and it's not as daunting.
Yeah.
And then once you've explored enough of each like cell, then you can kind of throw them all together and improvise.
Yeah, I like that idea. Yeah.
I think this is something that actually, like I've had the opportunity to work on a lot this semester because I'm also a jazz ed after this. So before, like the concept of improvisation, like I'm exactly in the same boat as Marissa, like it freaks me out, I'm not really comfortable with it, I don't like being that exposed. But when you have the opportunity to like do exploration, which like the way that you presented it was, like we're gonna find the baseline. Like a harmony line, like little pieces at a time that you're like, oh, well, it's just do ti do, like just little things like that. I'm comfortable with that because it's familiar, it's not scary, and then slowly transitioning into, well, that really is improvisation in its own way.
Right, exactly.
So just to translate it to that, like go through the different steps to be more comfortable with the concept of improvisation because you already have done it, just
right.
in a more contained kind of bubble.
Yeah, absolutely. I think what's important to remember is improvisation is not this thing where it's like you come up with this crazy new idea that no one's ever thought of before. You're really just like walking your way through this tune in a way that probably someone's done something similar before. You're probably using a lot of notes that other people use, and that's okay. That's the whole point. So we have these guidelines, and that's sort of what supports us in our improvisation. We need to move on to make sure we discuss your original tunes. Your next big assignment will be to compose two original tunes. Rather than showing you the guidelines first, we're going to start by listening to four previous examples of tunes. They're very short, so it'll only take a second. While we're listening to this, I want you to just think about, what do you think the guidelines for this assignment are? What do you think, what tonalities are these students writing in? How long is the tune? what kind of melodic ideas are they using. So we're going to listen to all four. If you want to take a second and write down the tonality and the meter for each one, we can maybe check in afterwards to see if we all agree about that. So, tune number one. These are all from previous semesters in MLV. I'll play. Let's hear that one more time. So let's hear it one more time. I wish you body excitement like this. Think about what maybe meter or tonality that is. We have two more to listen to. Responses for this one. One more time, same one. Going through those really quickly, let's check in. What did we get for the very first one? I think it was this one up here. Did anyone have a tonality in mind? Yeah, really?
Maybe Dory?
I heard Dory,
yeah,
too! You can give me a agree sign if you heard Dory. And does anyone know the agree sign in the same language? This means like, I feel the same thing you could give this sign.
Is it F?
Oh, I don't know about that.
Anyone with perfect pitch? I don't know.
I'm not sure. What meter are we in? So it was unusual, which means different length macro beats, and paired, which means we have two macro beats. I think it was ba 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 da ba da ba da ba da ba. Exactly. What about this one over here? Wait a second, let me listen to it. Yep.
Is that Lydian?
I heard Lydian too. You did resign if you heard Lydian. Yes. And what meter were we in? Someone else? Jason.
Triple.
Yes, I heard triple too. Exactly. Down here. Thoughts? Dotan?
I thought that was also Lydian.
That was also Lydian, that's exactly what I heard. And the meter? Yeah?
Duple?
This is the one that I had to go to Dr. Parker last semester and say, is this duple or this triple? Let's listen to that one again. You tell me. Triple. Who thinks duple? This one's like really on the fence for me. Because you have ba 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 ba. It could be ba 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 ba. Or it could be ba 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 ba. Her performance is sort of somewhere in between.
It felt like it started one thing and then shifted to the other.
I think we gave her credit for being in triple. All right, just because we are almost out of time, you need to write two original tunes.
But not right.
Sorry, excuse me, not right. And I apologize, I thought I had this pulled up. Let's just talk through this instead of me trying to pull up. No, it's right here. What do you notice based on these four tunes? What are the guidelines you think are going to be for this assignment? Jason?
Probably one and two full. Well, one like a usual meter, one unusual, some of that.
Yes, at least one of them needs to be in triple. You can do multiple in triple, or you could do unusual paired or unusual unpaired. Unusual paired would be like a 5/8, ba ba da ba da ba da ba ba. Unusual unpaired means there's three large beats, so ba da ba da ba da ba da four, ba da ba 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 da ba 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 ba. What other guidelines might exist for this assignment? Yes, Sam.
They have to be sung.
They have to be sung. Yes, you're going to turn in a sound recording or a video for this. You do not need to notate this. In fact, it is suggested that you should not notate them at all. When you are doing this, you should think about this orally. Sing to yourself. Think about putting these parts together. What about the length of the tune?
Short.
Short. Yes. In the description, we say 16 macro beats. So that's not really that long at all. You notice most of these tunes are maybe 15, 20 seconds at the longest. If you are uncomfortable, tonalities. What about tonalities?
Not major.
You can do one major tune, but you can only do one major tune, and the other one needs to be outside of major. If you want to do two that are outside of major, that is fantastic as well. We have some guidelines up here. We're also out of time, but if you are struggling, with getting your mind around some of the functions in the different tonalities, there is a guide. Thank you all. I'm sorry that I went a little bit over, but I really enjoyed teaching you guys, and have a wonderful day.